Welcome, everyone. I am Ana Flores. I'm the founder of We All Grow Latina, and I get the privilege of hosting these Amigas Mentor sessions with so many incredible women, such as Pam Covarrubias, who's joining us again here today in a webinar. But this time, I mean, this woman is multifaceted, such a beautiful healer, such a beautiful storyteller, and just really excited to have her today sharing this beautiful healing modality that she's been guided towards, which is EFT and tapping. I'll let her explain what it is, but today's topic is Let's Tap About It, Dealing with Change and Tapping During Difficult Times. And we will agree that we are going through uncertain and difficult times with a lot of perspective in them, but just privileged to be here and honored to be here with you and learning from you. So welcome, Pam.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here. OMG. Yes. Are we ready? So we're just going to
dive right in. This is all yours.
All right. Thank you, Anna, for the opportunity for creating this space, because I think it's perfect for the times that we're living in, the connection that we all need, especially me as an extrovert. Seeing people, even through a flat screen, it's still seeing people.
It's important.
Yes. So thank you for creating this space. All right. So let's tap about it. Let me see. I'm going to bring in my page. All right. So I am Pam Covarrubias. You can find me on Instagram at Covioaks. Which way do I go? So let's start talking about EFT. And I'm going to go fast and furious because I really want to get into the tapping. I don't want to talk too much. I want to tap. So my EFT story, I'll briefly share. I was very overwhelmed. I started tapping when I was still working in corporate. And I was, oh my gosh, working overworked, super anxious. And I was telling Anna that I have this thing in my life where I get really anxious when I drive on the freeway, because one of my healers told me one time that I died in a car accident before. And so when I'm driving, I get this, like, suddenly it's very random and I'm like, I'm gonna die today. And so tapping allowed me to, as I would drive, I started tapping on the steering wheel and we'll learn the tapping points, and that really helped me. Tapping has also helped me collapse limiting beliefs that I've had in every single aspect, whether it's money, self-worth, self-love, anything. It's really eye-opening, and I'll tell you more about it. And it's also helped me heal my inner child, because one thing that happens with me, and that's also something that Anna and I talked about, is I have a lot of memories blocked of my childhood. And that's because of the heavy trauma that I've endured. And so with tapping, what tapping has allowed me to do is to really uncover those blocked memories and clear them from my life, so they're no longer controlling me in a subconscious way. So tapping's been pretty powerful for me, and I had an opportunity to get trained to do clinical EFT, which allows us to go deeper into tapping. And I didn't want to show up with it because it was going to be one more thing that Pam does and I already do too much. But with this pandemic, when COVID was released, I woke up one morning and I was like, okay, I'm going to tap live. So I went on Instagram live and I started doing circle tapping live, and people really responded to it. And I kept hearing, like, this is what I needed at this moment. So it's all about that divine timing we talked about. And here we are today. So what is EFT? EFT stands for Emotional Freedom Techniques. And what EFT, it began in 1990. So it's not a super old technique. And what it does is inspired by acupuncture points. And acupuncture points, Chinese medicine, Ayurvedic medicine, and even Mayan medicine use acupuncture points. One question that I get all the time is this appropriation? And my answer is it's not, because I asked it in my class. It's not, because when we talk about tapping, we deeply acknowledge that it comes from the acupuncture points. So we don't just take it and run it. So it's deeply inspired in the acupuncture points. And the acupuncture points by Chinese medicine, they've been studied for 3,000 years. So we know. And if you've gotten acupuncture with the needles, you know, it's pretty powerful. So basically, EFT is emotional acupuncture without the needles, and we do it with our fingers. It's self-performed, which means that you can do it, I can do it, we can do it through a screen, and you can do it alone. And that's how I did a lot of my tapping, a lot of my healing work, through tapping by myself, and so, which is awesome. And my hope is that with us having today, you can take one tool in your toolbox that if you feel anxious or overwhelmed or anything, you can tap and it will hopefully help you. So how does it work? It's the question. La pregunta del millón is how does it work? So basically, it reduces the arousal that we have in our amygdala. And our amygdala is that little, it looks like a diamond. You can draw a diamond, it's a dot in there, but it's like a diamond-shaped little thing in our brain that is our fight or flight. I call it our fight or flight button. So back in the day when we used to be chased by tigers and lions and big animals, our amygdala would turn on when it was time to run. And so what's happening right now, as we live in this time, our amygdala has been on for a long time because we don't know what's happening in the world. We don't know what's happening with our work, where our houses are in chaos because all of a sudden we have to just live with a ton of people and spend time with each other for a long time. And so our amygdala has been turned on for a while. And what EFT allows us to do is it allows us to calm it down. To not necessarily turn it off, but to put it in a calm state. It also, the studies have shown that EFT reduces cortisol and improves your immunity. And I think I spelled immunity wrong there. So another thing that EFT does is it shifts your energy by rebalancing your body's energy system in relation to the thought or issue we tapped on. Another question that I get all the time, for especially for people who have never tapped, is why do we tap on the negative feeling? Because that's what we're going to do today. We're going to tap on that overwhelm and that anxiety and that feeling of unknown. We don't know what's happening. So why do we tap on the unknown, on the negative energy? Because it collapses it. So what EFT does is it almost like faces that feeling and then it cleans it out. And the way that I also explain it is as if we as humans, we are a big light bulb. And that light bulb, we have light that comes within us, but that light bulb is a little dirty. So what EFT does is it wipes it clean so that light can come out from within it. Things to keep in mind when we tap, and this is for you to take it moving forward as after we tap together, if you want to tap again on your own, things to keep in mind, it's important to be very specific. So if we're going to tap on anxiety, tap on that anxiety and only keep it on that, because otherwise your body gets confused. If we tap on anxiety, if we tap on like, I have a headache, then you're mixing and matching. We have to be very specific. We also, if possible, we want to find that feeling in our body. A lot of times, sometimes we get people that we just know that we're feeling a certain way. Other times, a lot of times, that feeling, we feel it somewhere in our body. So you want to find it. You want to give it a shape and a color if you can find that within you. And then check your SUDS. So SUDS stand for standard units of distress, SUDS, and basically is your intensity level. So before we start tapping, before we create a statement, we want to see, okay, so we identify the issue, right? We find it in the body if we can. And then we figure out where our intensity level is. So do we barely feel it, or is it on fire that we can't even stand it at a 10? And it's 1 to 10 because it's a simple scale. Always check your SUDS. Another thing to keep in mind, there's this amazing thing that happens when we do tapping circles like this, that's called borrowed benefits, which means that if, let's say, Anna and I are going to tap about something specific for her, all of you can still tap, should I invite you all to still tap with us, and you will benefit from the things that we're tapping on. So you will all receive healing because we're tapping in the circle and because energy travels around and we are creating this safe space. It's a container of healing that we're all tapping for each other. It's super magical. Another thing is allow your body to release. So I'm a yawner. Yo voy a estar bostezando the whole time because that's the way that my body releases. So you can release by sighing. I have a client that all she does is, that's how she releases. And that's her way that her body is releasing that unwanted energy that no longer serves us. So allow your body to release in whatever way. I have my tissue near me. So if you have some, you might have some tears also come up. You can burp. I had a classmate when I was in training that she, like, all she could do is burp. And it was in the beginning, it was like, whoa. But then we got used to it. You can laugh. Also, I've had people that get these laugh attacks, and there's, if that's the way that their body releases, you can get mucus coming from your nose. You can get, I didn't know the English word at the time. And you can also release gas. So however your body releases, let it. That's your body saying, thank you for allowing me to release. And most importantly, I want you to be safe. Please keep your eyes open when we do tapping, because we are tapping in acupuncture points and we are tapping on emotions. You could get memories triggered that could come to you. So if you get something that makes you feel uneasy, if you get a memory that you didn't want to think about, keep your eyes open otherwise, and then let me know so we can take care of you. Because if you keep your eyes closed, then you're going into the memory. We don't want to do that. Keep tapping the whole time, keep tapping, because as we tap along, that keeps all of us regulated. So don't stop tapping until we stop tapping, and then keep your eyes open. Okay, are we ready? I haven't looked at the chat. So I don't want to lose my train of thought. Okay. My Twitter handle is GoYukes. Yes. Okay, awesome. So are we all ready to start tapping? Let's take a deep breath. And I do want to ask you to tell me how you're showing up today. So how are we arriving? And check in with your body. We can take some deep breaths. And a good way to check in is we have a tapping point right here that's not in the illustration. But we have a tapping point in the middle of our chest. And that one allows you to really like check in with yourself, because it's your heart center. And your heart center is like super intense. And so if you can tap there, you just, how are we showing up today? Are we feeling excited? Are we ready? Are we overwhelmed? So we can say, Anna told me earlier that she had this back. We're feeling something in our back. So we can start tapping for her back.
My upper back and neck.
Okay. And then that will give you all an idea of how tapping works. So, okay, let's go through the points real quick. We have side of the hand, just right here. You can see it in the illustration. Then we do top of the head. So top of the head, see, I have my little phone. So top of the head is right here. So it's not in the front, it's not in the back. It's the mollera, you know, where like babies, when they tell you, little babies don't push there in their head because they get like it's shallow, I don't know. So that's the top of the head. Then we have eyebrow point, which is right where your eyebrow begins. Side of the eye, it's right where your eye ends. Under the eye is right, that little bone under your eye. Under the nose, literally under your nose. Under the mouth, you tap under your mouth. I use a lot of fingers. Some people use just one. It's up to you. And then we do the collarbone. So the collarbone is about 2 inches, right where you have your little bones right here, your collarbone. About 2 inches under, there's a squishy part in your chest where that is. You can feel it. And then under the arm, it's about 4 inches under your arm. And about 4 inches, about a hand. So if you measure your hand, then right there is the point. And you can start tapping and you'll feel when the real one is. And then that's it. So what we do before we start, since we're gonna tap on Anna's back stuff, what we do is we create a statement. And the statement we say it 3 times. One for mind, one for body, and one for soul. And the statement needs to feel true to you. So there's a formula to create the statement. So the statement begins with, even though I feel I exist this way, I accept myself. Sometimes, because we're living in crazy times, we don't feel like we accept ourselves at the moment. So what I've been saying is I exist today, or I show up today, because that feels more true. And it's happened when I've done sessions when I say I accept myself and my clients are like, nope, not today. So we have to make sure that it's what feels true to you. Okay, so.
Before you go in, Monica's asking, does it matter if it's on the left or the right side?
It doesn't matter. Mm-mm. So you can tap on this eyebrow, you can tap on this eyebrow. It doesn't matter. You can tap on both if you want. The benefit's the same. The collarbone is the one that people tap different. I use both hands. Some people use one hand and they tap both like this. And some people just use one. It doesn't matter because our body So, any questions about the tapping points? Any questions about tapping before we get started? Okay, let's do this. So, okay, everyone take a deep breath. So let's tap on Anna's back stuff. So, Anna, let me ask you some questions to find the actual state. Before we create the statement, we want to ask some questions. So what is it that you're feeling?
I am feeling since yesterday a huge weight on my neck and on my back, just like I need a massive massage to untangle everything.
It 1 to 10, how intense is it?
It's like an 8.
An 8? Which one's bigger, the neck or the back?
The point where the neck and the shoulders meet.
Mm. Is there a shape or a color?
I just saw green and like a trunk.
A trunk.
Like roots and a trunk.
So we're going to create the statement and we're going to begin the tapping round, and everyone watching, tap with us. This is why it's a tapping circle, because we're all tapping for each other. So as we tap along and we go through the points, if something comes up, if you get a thought, interrupt me and tell me what's happening.
Okay.
Because that's your body telling you what's going on. We're going to, you follow my tapping. So you're going to mirror what I'm doing. Everyone's going to mirror what we're doing. Okay. So let's tap on the side of the hand. Even though I feel this green trunk on my neck and my back, please get up for me.
Even though I feel this green trunk on the neck of my back,
I exist today.
I exist today.
Even though I feel this green trunk on my back,
Even though I feel this green trunk on my neck and my back.
I exist today.
I exist today.
Even though I feel this green trunk on my back and my neck.
Even though I feel this green trunk on my back and my neck.
I exist today.
I exist today.
Top of the head. This green trunk.
This green trunk?
That's on my eyebrow, that's on my neck.
That's on my neck.
Side of the eye, on my back.
On my back.
Under the eye. And I feel it so intense.
And I feel it so intense.
Under the nose, and it's been bothering me since yesterday.
Bothering me since yesterday.
And it feels like green.
It feels like green.
Is it still green?
It's moving to my chest. Like, I'm just feeling like I need to sigh my chest out.
Sigh it out. Let it out. Whatever needs to come out. And it's in my back.
And it's in my back.
And I feel like I need a massage because of it.
And I feel like I need a massage because of it.
Okay. Shake it up. 1 to 10. Did it go up, down, or stay the same?
I feel like energy all over, so I started feeling it hit my my solar plexus, and that's when I started feeling like I needed to sigh, and then my chest, and I still feel kind of tight there, but then my feet just felt like sweaty chills.
Okay, so where do you feel it now? So it can move, so that's beautiful, because that means that our body's like, whoa, you're trying to do something here, let's move it up.
You know, I don't feel it as much in my shoulders anymore, but I do in my neck, in the back of my neck.
Is that higher? Or the chest?
No, the neck, the back of the neck.
Okay, 1 to 10.
Like 4.
Is it a shape or a color?
I see brown now.
Brown? Uh-huh. Could you describe the feeling?
Now, this is crazy, but it's starting to go away.
Okay. let's collapse it one more time. Okay. So what do you feel now?
It's traveling a little bit towards my lower back, more around the spine.
And how, so let's tap about it. So okay. Describe it. Where is it going?
It feels like almost like energy pulses traveling down my back, down my spine on the sides.
And what is it feeling? Eyebrow.
No,
Side of the eye. Where is it going?
it's just kind of radiating all over,
Under the eye.
but
Under
it's not in
the
the same place anymore.
Is it uncomfortable?
No,
Nice.
I'm a sire. I love it.
You're a sire.
No, but I feel like I feel that as that because it's in my chest. I feel like if I just sigh,
Collarbone.
I can release it. Like it doesn't feel stuck anymore.
Okay. Could you describe it on your chest? Under the arm.
It's just it's pressure.
Is there a shape or a color?
Red circle.
Okay, so let's have fun. Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest.
Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest,
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest.
Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest,
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
And feel free to change it. If something doesn't want to come out, then say whatever it wants to. Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest.
Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest,
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Top of the head. This pressure on my chest.
No, I just want to laugh.
Laugh. This
That's
pressure on my
all I need. I just need to laugh.
chest. Yeah. Eyebrow. This pressure on my chest.
Even though I feel this red circle pressure on my chest.
We'll just tap on the pressure. Just pressure. This pressure. Under the eye. This pressure. Woo, here we go.
Okay, it's
It's from
ready
me
to
to
tell my
you.
feet again, and it feels like
Oh my
when you
goodness.
breath work with Ana Lila, that she's like releases dark smoke out of your feet. That's how I feel. Like it's
So it's in
just
your feet? Okay, so if it traveled that fast, then we can stop the session and I mean the round and tap it on the feet. So what do you feel on the feet?
I'm tingly.
So even though I feel tingling in my feet.
I feel tingly in my feet, yeah.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I feel tingling in my feet.
Even though I feel tingly in my feet.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I feel tingling in my feet.
Even though I feel tingly in my feet.
I feel t I'm here today.
I'm here today. I'm present.
I'm present with the tingles in my feet.
I'm present with the tingles in my feet. And it's bringing me joy.
Eyebrow.
Eyebrow.
This joy I have in my feet.
This joy I have in my feet.
Side of the eye. I feel the tingle in my feet.
I feel a tingling in my feet.
Under the eye.
You're yawning. I love it.
And this feeling I have in my feet.
This feeling I have in my feet.
Under the nose. And this energy that traveled all over my body, now it's in my feet.
And this energy that traveled all over my body is now on my feet.
And I feel it tingly.
And I feel it tingly.
And it's tingly.
Yeah, I just feel like I'm ready to move.
Under the arm. Oh, the energy on my feet.
Energy on my feet.
Check it out. Everyone else, how are you feeling? Good.
They're feeling it going through their arms.
Okay. Energy going through my arms. Okay. How are you feeling, Anna?
I'm good. I just seriously I feel just like laughing and moving and like something was stuck there and was holding me down and now I'm just like, okay, I'm free. Let me move around.
Yes. So it's very activating. So I use also tapping. You know, I'm a recovering procrastinator. Everyone knows this. And I use tapping for to get me out of to snap me out of it because it's very energizing. You can also do tapping to relax. So you can also tap to release. So for everyone else, you're feeling is anyone feeling something really intense that wants to come on and we can tap for you?
I can open your mic too. Cecilia Ponce is saying that sensations she has honestly never felt before.
Let's talk about it. Let's tap about
Cecilia, you want me to open? I'll open your mic. I'll allow you to talk and you can choose to open your mic. There we go.
Hola, Cecilia.
Hola.
How are you doing?
I'm good. I've honestly been going through a lot of like just emotional stuff this quarantine, and I've been meditating every day. So all this stuff, like I really believe in it. And it totally makes so much sense. And I've been having some left shoulder pain. So I would love to talk about that if
it can help. Do you feel it now?
A little bit, yeah.
Which shoulder?
My left.
Could you describe the feeling?
It's like I work out a lot. So for me, I thought that it was, you know, just a soreness. But I think it's possibly just the way that I've been sleeping. So it's like a muscly soreness pain.
Okay. Is there a shape or a color?
I guess for me, I just always think of red when I have pain.
Okay. What's your intensity level? 1 to 10.
Oh, it's like a 3. It's just because everything else is good for me. But so whenever something is wrong with my body, it's very, like, I am aware of it.
You hold it in your shoulders typically?
Yes.
Okay. So let's do a quick tap.
Okay.
So even though I feel tingly, you said? No.
I guess just like a little bit of soreness.
Soreness. Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Does that feel good? Does that feel true?
Yeah.
Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
Even though I feel this red soreness in my shoulder.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Woo! There I went for you. Top of the head. The soreness in my shoulder.
The soreness in my shoulder.
Eyebrow. The soreness in my shoulder.
The soreness in my shoulder.
This red feeling 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 in my shoulder.
This feeling I'm carrying on my shoulder.
This feeling I'm carrying in my shoulder.
Anything come up?
It's crazy because it's kind of like going away. Like, it's hard to believe, but it's...
It's real.
It's so real.
Under the mouth, this feeling that's going away.
This feeling that's going away.
Collarbone, this feeling that I carry on my shoulders.
This feeling that I'm carrying on my shoulders.
Under the arm, this feeling I have on my shoulders.
This feeling I have on my shoulder.
Ooh. There we go. So did it go up, down, or same thing?
I think it went down. This is crazy. This is like magic. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Oh my gosh. Other people, you guys should do it. You guys should do this.
So, and that's what I love doing tapping circles, because it's quick. And the borrowed benefits, it's super true. I've done one-on-one sessions that are super powerful, but when we do tapping circles, it's like, it increases it like so much because everyone's tapping. So somebody else had it in their shoulders. No, in their arms, right?
Wants to raise their hands or...
Yeah, let's tap. If not, I have an exercise that we can do. Don't be shy. Or we can just tap for the overwhelm. So everyone's had a lot of, like Cecilia said, a lot of... Can you use EFT for weight? We can use EFT... Okay. It depends on what that means. So that's a broad question. We can use EFT for cravings, yes. And I did it for a craving that I had for salt vinegar chips. I love salt vinegar chips. And so it was this experiment. So I was like, let me see, because I really want to eat them. So I tapped about it, and I didn't want to eat them anymore. So we can tap for cravings. There's a Q&A, I think.
Yeah, Carla, do you want me... Carl, I'm going to go ahead and open your mic. I mean, allow you to talk and you can open your mic so you can ask a question.
Yeah. Okay.
Hola, hola.
How are you guys?
Good. How are you?
Hola. My question is it the same technique or what you said, if it's like a physical pain or like anxiety?
Yeah. So, yes. Okay. Because do you have anxiety?
Yeah, I feel I mean, I have, I suffer from anxiety, but right now I have a headache, but this is another story. So I was wondering if I should, in this case, I'm like, I'm going to do like separate them both, do for one and then for the other. Okay.
Yes. Okay. So we can tap on your headache if you want. So here's the caveat. When it comes to bodily pains, we want to check in with our intuition. It's very, very important. Because I'll tell you a quick story that happened in class, actually. And my teacher was like, I'm so glad this happened in class so you could witness it. So there was a student in class, and she had this stomach pain. And this, like, she thought it was indigestion, and because people traveled. And she went up to the teacher, and she was like, I have this like pain in my belly. Could we tap about it? And the teacher was like, let's sit on it. Let's wait a second, maybe eat something else. We'll see. And it ended up being appendicitis. So at the next day, my teacher was like, look, had I not listened to that message that I received for not tapping on her, we would have collapsed the pain and then it could have gotten worse. So it's that EFT is that powerful, right? So when it comes to all that to say, and I don't know why I was told to say this, because it's important to check in with yourself. So for your headache, that could be also your body telling you, you could be dehydrated, you could be different things. So you can tap on it, but it's important to hear the messages as you get them.
Okay.
So you can tap on your headache.
Thank you.
Yeah. How are you? How's your headache? What's the intensity for your headache?
It's like a 7. It's on the sides of my head, and I think that's related to stress too.
which side?
I feel the right side more than the left right now.
Okay.
Yeah,
would
it's
you,
like a pounding.
Pounding?
Yeah.
Is there a color?
No, I don't see a color.
So we have a 7 headache, pounding. Okay, so let's tap the side of the hand. Everyone, let's tap today. Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head, in color reflective.
Sorry, I was muted. Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Does that feel true?
Yes.
Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head.
Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head.
Even though I have this pounding headache on the right side of my head.
I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Top of the head. This pounding headache.
Pounding headache.
On the right eyebrow. On the right side of my head.
The right side of my head.
Side of the eye. This pounding headache.
Pounding headache.
Under the eye. On the right side of my head.
The right side of my head.
Woo! Here we go. This headache.
This headache.
Oh, this headache.
Oh, this headache.
Oh, this headache.
Oh, this headache.
Under the arm. Oh, this headache.
Oh, this headache.
Okay, shake it off. Oh. Did it go up, down, stay the same, or did it move somewhere else?
Wow, this is crazy. Okay, it's not pounding anymore.
Good.
I feel it a little down to the neck, but it's
okay.
Like a 2.
Man, nice.
This is incredible. Wow.
So we either want to always collapse it 2 or less. So we can keep it at a 2 if you feel okay, or we can try to collapse it one more time.
Okay. No, it's okay. I think I can. This is crazy. Okay.
So to answer the question about, thank you for showing up. To answer the question about your anxiety and headaches and bodily pains, again, going back to what we talked about in the and keep it stick. So we tapped on the headache and we stayed on the headache. It might feel repetitive for our brain, but for our body, it's not. Our body is getting the message that we're tapping just on that thing. So if you get the anxiety, tap on the anxiety. And sometimes anxiety, look, I have anxiety. So I know sometimes it could be in your chest. Sometimes it could be a headache. Sometimes it could just be like a complete overwhelm, crazy stuff. So try to get as specific as possible to when you tap on everything.
Right, and then you tap until it's gone, basically.
Ideally, you want it 3 is like pushing it, 2 or less.
Okay.
On intensity awesome. Level.
Thank you so much, Pam.
Thank you.
That's it, Carla. So now we're getting deep into the questions. I think you're really going to like the lens question.
Let's see.
Belen, you're allowed to talk. Just open up your mic.
Hi, Belen.
You need to unmute yourself.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
I had a question. You said that you tap procrastination, and I feel like in this time of quarantine, I've been having the worst time finding my focus in school.
Okay.
I was wondering if you can tell me how I can tap.
Let's tap. So what are you, so one of the things that you said is that you are having a hard time focusing.
Mm-hmm.
And what's happening? What are the distractions?
I feel like there's like a mental block in my head that's just like, I don't want to do schoolwork right now. Like that just feels like too heavy.
1 to 10, how much do you not want to do schoolwork?
Like an 8.
Yeah. Even though I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
Even though I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
I'm here. Even though I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
Even though I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
If something comes up, if you need to release in any way, do it. And tell me if something comes up. Even though, I'm sorry, I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
No, sorry, I don't want to do schoolwork right now.
Eyebrow. I don't feel like doing schoolwork right now.
I don't feel like doing schoolwork right now.
Set of the eye. It's too much.
It's too much.
Under the eye. I don't feel like doing schoolwork right now.
I don't feel like doing schoolwork right now.
Under the nose. There's a lot going on.
There's a lot going on.
Under the nose. And I don't feel like doing anything.
I don't feel like doing anything.
Under the neck. And I feel that I really don't want to do schoolwork.
And I feel like I really don't want to do schoolwork.
Under the arm. And it's been hard to focus.
It's been hard to focus.
Shake it up. Did anything come up?
No.
What did you feel?
I felt like pressure on my shoulders.
Okay. Any shape or color?
No.
How intense is the pressure on your shoulders?
Like a 5.
Yeah. Even though I feel this pressure on my shoulders.
And I feel this pressure on my shoulders.
I exist.
I exist.
Even though I feel this pressure on my shoulders.
I feel this pressure on my shoulders.
Here we go. I exist.
Like.
Even though I feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
I feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
I exist.
I exist.
Top of the head. I feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
I feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
Eyebrow. All this pressure I have on my shoulders.
Pressure I have on my shoulders.
Side of the eye. All this pressure I feel on my shoulders.
Pressure I feel on my shoulders.
Oh, yeah. All this pressure on my shoulders.
All this pressure on my shoulders.
Under the nose. I feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
Feel all this pressure on my shoulders.
Under the mouth. Oh, all this pressure.
Pressure.
Yeah. All this pressure I feel.
All this pressure I feel.
On my shoulders. Woo! Check it out. What happened?
I started feeling tingly in my arms and my feet.
Okay. Did any thoughts, feelings come up?
Just a tingle.
How intense is the tingle? Lots of tingles too.
4?
4? Is it still there or is it gone now that we stopped talking?
Now that we stopped talking, it's mostly on my feet.
Okay. So even though I feel this tingle on my feet.
I feel this tingle on my feet.
Actually, let's tap about it. What's going on in your feet? And you just tell me, just answer. Mirror what I'm doing. As I ask questions and just answer what comes to mind, don't overthink it. What's going on in your feet, Belen?
it feels like the tingly is kind of like moving towards my toes, like it's like wants to move me forward.
Wants to move you forward where?
And now straight ahead.
How come?
I don't know.
What's stopping you?
That I'm sitting.
Okay. And what are you feeling right now?
A sense of relief.
1 to 10, how relief are you?
5.
And how much do you want to do school work?
6.
A 6 yes or a 6 no?
6 yes.
Okay. What do you need to get motivated to do more schoolwork?
I think this is helping a lot. I think if I just
check it up. So what I'm feeling is that there's more that we need to uncover of why there's a block of not focusing. From a recovering procrastinator standpoint, there's a lot of things that help you, that prevent you from moving forward. And so what's beautiful that I heard is that you had this feeling of like propelling you, so you're ready, but there's something in there stopping it. So, and you got some relief. How are you feeling right now?
Better.
So when you think about doing schoolwork, what comes to mind?
The idea of just accomplishing it.
And the idea of, and what does that mean?
Like, just a sense of relief that I did it. Like, that's what comes to mind when I think about it now.
Nice. So for you, let's bring in some good positive thoughts. So let's bring in, do you need to do schoolwork today?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's do some, this is called choice. So we're going to choose to accomplish what we need to accomplish today. So this might help everyone. Today, I choose to complete all my tasks.
I choose to complete all my tasks.
I give myself permission to get the things done.
I give myself permission to get the things done.
And I also give myself compassion if I don't feel like it.
And I also give myself compassion if I don't feel like it.
I give myself permission to take breaks.
I give myself permission to take breaks.
And I also give myself permission to be focused.
And I also give myself permission to be focused.
Because I know I want to do schoolwork.
Because I know I want to do school.
Just sometimes maybe I just need a break.
Just sometimes maybe I just need a break.
Because of what's going on in the world.
Because of what's going on in the world.
Today, I let myself be.
Today, I let myself be.
Okay, check it out. How are you feeling?
I feel a lot better. I feel looser and just a little more uplifted.
Nice. Awesome. Good. So I think, so this is what we did. This is choice hopping. So we introduced a belief, temporary belief. So it's going to last today because we told our body and mind, we said, today we're going to do this. Tomorrow you might feel a little off again. You can do the same. And it's a work in progress. Cool?
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks, Ellen. So Pat, there's a few more questions. So how does it work? How does it, the saying the words, right, the phrases that you say, connect with the actual tapping and the acupressure?
Point. So basically what happens as we tap, we're activating. So these are meridian points. And one thing that I didn't mention earlier is that humans naturally, we tap. So we think about, if sometimes we can't find something and we're like, oh, can't find it, where is it? So we naturally just tap, And this one is something that we just do all the time. Like, oh my God, it's very natural. We just do it. So what we do as we're creating the statement, so this is connecting to our brain and it's telling our brain, it's creating a neural pathway.
It's creating neural pathways. Okay. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. So it's, we're retraining. This is manifesting and et cetera. We're just retraining it with something more direct than just proclaiming and doing affirmations.
Great for manifesting. Great for manifesting.
Yeah. So Ana Laura is actually, I'm just going to ask her a question because it's related. Is there a resource of phrases or statements to use when doing tapping? She's like, I feel like they're all so positive and I am such a pessimist, I would struggle.
It's actually okay to tap on the negative stuff. We've been tapping on the negative stuff. So we've been tapping on the pain, right? And so are there phrases? It depends. So I do have an exercise where it's an affirmation exercise, actually. But we work on the tail end of the exercise, which is something that we, when it comes to affirmations, we talk about like, I am abundant. And there's that little voice in your head that says, wait, not yet, but blah, 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 right? And that little voice, that's what we tap on. So to answer the question, you can find affirmations that you want to tap on if you want. And then, but really check in on the inner voice that tells you that's not true. You're not there yet. It's going to take a minute, whatever that is. And so you tap on that. Even though I don't think I'm abundant yet, I'm here. Even though I don't think I'm abundant yet. Or even though I don't believe that I'm healthy. And then you do a round, because what that does is it's collapsing that negative voice. So it allows the light to come in for the positive affirmation. The answer to the question.
It's powerful.
Very much so.
Okay. Ana Laura, sorry I didn't open your mic, but let me know if you want to speak and we can definitely open if you want to follow up with this. Oh, she's saying so powerful. Thank you. Before we go to Yvonne, Monica is asking if there's any counterindications, saying that like it's under the nose and some energetic modalities is sometimes contraindicated for pregnancy. What about
No, because you're not just tapping on under the nose. You know, we're doing the sequence. Mm-hmm. So if you are pregnant, there is one point that you do not tap when you're pregnant, and that's under your leg, which I'm not perfect, like that one's a very off point. It works really, I use it sometimes when clients are really stuck in something and it doesn't come out, but I need to make sure that they're not pregnant. Otherwise that induces labor, but that's under your leg. The nose, as long as you do it with the sequence, you should be fine.
Okay, so Yvonne has a very powerful one. That's why I'm leaving her to last right now, because I think most of us can relate in some way or another. And there's obviously, this issue is multidimensional, but Yvonne, you're allowed to talk.
Hola, Pam. Oh. I'm excited that you're talking about this, because something that came up is lack mentality, like making money lack mentality. I feel like I'm unworthy of receiving, like things that are coming up is I feel weird charging people for money. Like if I, you know, helping them with something, like I want to give, like that's just me, my giving heart, like I want to help, but I feel weird asking people to pay me, right? So
I love this question.
And, you know, and then right now, like everyone's like even struggling even more. So I feel even worse, like charging people for money. So it's like, oh my goodness.
Yes. Let's tap about it. So one thing that came up, like as soon as you started talking, is I feel unworthy of charging. Mm-hmm. How true does that feel?
Yeah, it feels very true. Like it feels very emotional, like a 10.
Do you feel it somewhere in your body?
Right now I just feel like tingly all over, but I do have some sort of pressure on my upper back.
Okay. Let's tap. So even though I feel unworthy of charging, is that the statement?
Even though I feel unworthy of charging.
Does that feel true?
Yes.
I'm here.
I'm here.
Even though I feel unworthy of charging.
Even though I feel unworthy of charging.
I'm here. Even though I feel unworthy of charging.
Even though I feel unworthy of charging. I'm here.
I feel unworthy of charging.
I feel unworthy of charging.
Especially now.
Especially now.
I feel like I can't charge people.
I feel like I can't charge people.
And I just want to give.
I just want to give.
And I don't feel worthy of charging.
I don't feel worthy of charging.
What's coming up? So I just want to give.
Sorry, say it again. There's a big truck that went by.
Because I just want to give.
Oh, because I just want to give.
And I feel this feeling that I can't charge people.
I have this feeling that I can't charge people.
And it's showing tingly all over my body.
It's feeling tingly all over my body.
What came up?
It feels less. Now it feels like my right shoulder, upper arm feels some pressure. Like it was the whole upper back, some movement, but now it feels like it's going to my right shoulder, upper arm. Right.
Okay. Okay. 1 to 10?
8.
And what is the feeling, or you just feel something around your arm? Or is it still feeling on my feet?
Yeah, the tingly still feels all over, not as much. But yeah, it feels more tingly on my feet and my upper right arm.
Okay.
And my shoulder.
So if I tell you, Yvonne, you have to charge people, what do you feel?
Awkward.
Okay. Even though I feel awkward charging people.
Even though I feel awkward charging people.
I'm here. Even though I feel awkward charging people.
Even though I feel awkward charging people.
I am here today. Even though I feel awkward charging people.
Even though I feel awkward charging people.
I'm here today. I feel weird asking people for money.
I feel weird asking people for money.
Feels awkward. I feel this tingle on my arm.
My shoulder.
Because it feels awkward to ask people for money.
Because it feels awkward to ask people for money.
I feel weird asking people for money.
I feel weird asking people for money.
And it feels awkward charging.
It feels awkward charging.
And I feel awkward about it. And
I
feel it on my upper shoulder and arm.
Upper shoulder and arm.
Okay. Shake it up. What happened?
It feels like on my wrist.
That's right, crazy wrist.
Yeah, my right wrist.
Your receiving hand.
Right hand.
So your right wrist, what are you feeling?
It's not pressure anymore. But it's just like something stuck, it kind of feels like.
I don't feel as tingly anymore on my body. Even though it feels like something stuck.
I feel like something stuck.
In my wrist. I exist. Even though I feel something stuck on my wrist. I exist. Even though I feel something stuck in my wrist.
Even though I feel something stuck on my wrist.
I exist. Top of the head. There's something stuck on my wrist. It's my right wrist. I feel like there's something stuck. It's just there. I feel it like it's stuck. It's my right wrist.
Ooh,
and I feel it on my right wrist.
And I feel it on my right wrist.
And I feel it like it's stuck.
Feel like it's stuck.
Okay, check it out. What happened?
Well, that's pretty good. I don't feel it anymore.
So when it comes to charging, what's the feeling right now?
Yeah, it feels like a 4 now. Like it feels like a lot. Like more like, okay, I think I can do this kind of feeling. Like before it felt like, oh, I don't know, like it's so tough. And now it feels like, okay, yeah. It feels better. Like,
so if I tell you Yvonne needs to charge people, send an invoice. What do you feel?
There's a slight hesitation, but it's not like the big fear.
What's a hesitation?
Like you're being vulnerable. Yeah, thank you for helping. Like I feel like they're gonna say that's too much.
Even though I'm afraid people think are gonna think I charge too much.
Even though people are gonna, I feel like people are gonna say I charge too much.
I'm worth it.
I'm worth it.
Does that feel true? You can say not yet.
Yeah, not yet.
Okay. I'm here today.
I'm here today.
Even though I'm afraid that people are gonna think I charge too much.
Even though I feel like people are gonna think I charge too much.
Out of here.
I'm here.
That's the one. Even though I feel.
Even though I feel.
People are gonna think I charge too much.
People are gonna think I charge too much.
I'm here.
I'm here.
Top of the head. I have this fear.
I have this fear.
That people are going to think I charge too much.
People are gonna think I charge too much.
And they're not gonna wanna pay me.
And they're not gonna wanna pay me.
So why charge anyway?
So why charge anyway?
Because they might say I charge too much.
Because they might say I charge too much.
And I have this fear.
And I have this fear.
That they're not going to want to pay me.
They're not going to want to pay me.
Or they might think it's too much.
Or they might think it's too much.
What happened?
Wow, I like felt tingly, like a rush shooting out through my hands.
Nice. How's your right hand?
Yeah, I don't feel anything on my right hand anymore.
So when I say you won't send that invoice.
Yeah, I can do it.
Awesome.
Yeah, that feels true now.
Yay.
Well, that's so cool.
I love it. Thank you.
Oh my goodness. Thank you so much. Wow.
Thank you.
I didn't think you would be this fast. But thank you for giving me the space, and thank you all for the support as well.
No, thank you for showing up, because this is something that's hard to talk about and not often talked enough. So it's very brave. Thank you for showing up.
You're welcome.
We can't hear you, Anna. You're muted. Can't hear Anna.
Sorry. Okay. All right. No, I was just saying thank you so much. We've run out of time.
Yes.
And the last question is just so if we want to continue. So I know you're doing them on Instagram, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. I was showing up every Wednesday, but life got busy. And then I'm doing one-on-one with clients, but I'm showing up on Instagram to do tapping circles, and we can do like tapping circles. I've done tapping circles for families because they're like with each other. And so we literally sit down with the whole family and do it. I've done it with friends. Yeah, we can just keep going.
Where can we find this image?
It's on my Instagram, but I can send it to you.
Okay, perfect. So if we want to do it on our own, it's just whatever is coming to us as we're going through the sequence. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep. Yep. And this is what I love about tapping, that you can do it on your own. Yeah. So check in with the feeling that's the most intense, okay. The one that's the highest. That's what you want to tap about.
All right. Well, thank you for this beautiful tool. I know we all need as many tools in our toolbox right now, and there's different tools that speak to different people. So those of you that are here, the recording is going to be up soon in a few days. If there's anybody that came to mind that you think needs this, we can share it, share Pam's info as well to reach out to her. And Pam, what is something that we can do for you?
Oh my gosh, I healed with all of you, so we just did a ton of healing together.
All right, well, thank you. I invite all of you to continue joining us. Checking in on WeAllGrow Amigas at our events tab. We have two really great webinars, Amigas Mentors webinars next week, one with Dani Luna, which will be checking on this ratio of creating versus consuming, which is definitely very important right now. We want to be on the creating aspect of that ratio. And then we have one that we haven't announced yet with Amazon Kindle Direct Publishing to publish our ebooks, our books, etc., and get them sold on the Amazon Marketplace. So an incredible tool for all of us. And again, on Mondays, our holding hands coaching sessions with Wendy Amara, which are so great. It's a free hour of therapy, of coaching every week, and our office hours on Tuesday. So I'll see you all. Have a fabulous weekend. Gracias, Pam.
Gracias. Drink lots of water, everyone.
Okay.
We released the time.
Yes, good reminder.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.